Hi there, Eric Bakker, Naturopath. Thanks for coming back and looking at the video. I've got an interesting one here from a person called Borific. Mr. Borific. Hi, Dr. Bakker. I have a question. I've been increasingly sicker over the course of the past 10 years. A lot of it seems to be GI related, though I'm not convinced that's the root of it all. I've been tested for several things and everything has been negative so far. One thing is extremely high folate levels. I'm not supplementing with any B vitamins. My system can't handle it, so that's not causing it. What else causes super high folate levels? I've also very high uracil and normal thiamine levels, according to the oat test. Nobody I've talked to has been able to answer this question. Thank you so much. Well, Mr. Borific, or Mrs. Borific, or, I mean, this could be a 10-year-old child for all I know. I don't know who does these questions half the time, but whoever wrote this, you need to be very careful. Why wasn't the stool test done before the oat test? In my opinion, that would have been a better test to do. When you're starting to poke around and have a look at these pathways and defects, there can be many, many, many reasons for it. It could also be the test could be incorrect, or something could have been done that was wrong, giving you this kind of level. So don't be scared, you know, jumping on the bandwagon with crazy treatments because of one trick, one test shows this kind of result, okay? So if you look at uracil, uracil is what we call a nuclear base. So there are four nuclear bases that make up, for example, RNA, and uracil is one of them. I think the other one are adenine and guanine, and they've got weird names. I think it's A, C, G, and U are the four bases, and uracil is one of the four bases. But in DNA, it's different because the uracil is replaced by the thiamine. You might have already researched on that. So it gets a bit complicated. What you're looking at it is a very small but important pathway that can be affected by a whole bunch of other different things happening in the digestive system. So my question to you is, what did the gut show? If you did do a stool test, did you show any kind of dysbiotic bacteria or any issues? You know, I would tend to ignore the high folate levels if you're not supplementing them. So if you're only just eating, getting folate through your diet, you're not going to die of the folate toxicity because I doubt you're going to take any more than about 1,000 micrograms in per day. You won't be drinking a gallon of spinach juice, you know, with each meal. So folate is extremely important nevertheless because it helps to mature red blood cells. And it's so important, in fact, that most governments around the world, like in New Zealand and America, they started to make this ruling. I think it came in the 90s, 98, 99, where all breads and cereal grains were fortified with folic acid. And why would this be? Well, folate is such an important B vitamin. It's extremely important for prevention of most chronic disease like cancer. It forms the basis of cellular reproduction. So folate is just one of those things that if you've got low levels, you're basically going to develop really shitty cells. You're going to develop crap cells, you're going to get cancer, you're going to get sick. So for proper buildup of blood cells and cells in the body in general that divide, and for the proper health of especially of any cell in the body, you need good levels of folic acid. So that's why they really like folate for pregnant women, because of course as the baby's growing rapidly and the cells are dividing, you need good levels of folate to provide that. Best levels of folate really are the deep leafy green vegetables. I'm seeing on websites now like Healthline and WebMD and crap like that, they're actually saying the best source of folate is bread now. Come on, get out of here. Stupid idea. I suppose the best form of sugar is Coca-Cola now, isn't it? Get out of here. The best form of folate is fresh produce that comes out of an organically grown garden. That's the best level of folate. I may have mentioned this previous on a video. It's one of the world's biggest problems is folate deficiency. And this person's saying they've got too much folate in their body. I would disregard that. You know, I can't really see serious side effects coming from folate levels, you know, unless, you know, we're talking like ridiculous levels. So what do you do in this case? Well, Mr. or Mrs. Borific, I would recommend a comprehensive stool analysis, including parasitology, performed properly, you know, meaning the proper withholding of probiotics and supplements, you know, the appropriate time beforehand, to test them properly, and then let's see what's wrong with the digestive system. You mentioned here A lot of it seems GI related, then the gut needs fixing first. It's the foundation. Oat test, in my opinion, is not the correct test to do before the stool test. You know, you don't clean the glass and polish the windows on the car until you've washed all the crap off the paintwork first. Come on. You can't have your pudding unless you've had your meat. You've got to do one thing before the other, all right? So get the stool done first. Get the foundation of the gut in good shape. And then let the body, in its wisdom, handle the correct healthy diet that you're consuming. And then let it improve your metabolism. And then do your oat test in time to see if you can fine-tune that. But to do an oat test before a stool test, to me, it's just a dumb idea. Right? Have a think about it. Don't freak out about the folate. I think it's perfectly fine. Take care.